these are the cases that we've done in FIT, and it's, these are done by residents, no consultant was involved. In one day, we did the preparations and scans and milling on one day and cementation on the next day. Because there were a lot of billions, so it takes time for cementation on the next day. So we did them on the next day. This is another case. This patient has company is done, but they are not discolored and some of them are chipped off. So we wanted them new. So we told him that rather than doing composite veneers again, why not ceramic veneers? This is another case that we did. This is also a female patient who had her marriage in 1 week. After preparations, cementation of the veneer. This is another case of an all ceramic crown. You can see the margins, 1 mm shoulder all around, and supra-gingival margins. Because of all ceramic crowns, you don't need to box up gingival because the shade matching is very good. This is the crown after milling. This is an E-max, which is basically a medium. After glazing and staining, cementation. You can see how the anatomy has been replicated. Buckle contour as well. And this is the picture of the machine. This is the select AC. AC means acquisition center. This is the screen. And this is the intraoral camera. You can, it has wheels, you can move it anywhere. Scan the prosthesis and design it at your own layer. Or if the patient is present, you need to make it from in between an hour, so you can do it as well. And this is the milling machine. This is a short video. After, when we place the block, the machine checks by touching the burr slightly as that the same block that was selected in the software has been inserted, and then the milling process takes place. These are the spindles. Each spindle has two motors and special burrs have been inserted. They are diamond burr, but they are of special shape and dimension. This is the milling process from another view. And when the milling is completed, the light turns green. This is the block, remaining block, and the prosthesis is lying here. And this is the furnace that we have. It is also of Sirona in fire HPC speed. The reason that we need a special furnace for cadmium is because of sintering of zirconia. For zirconia, you need the to go up to temperatures of 1400 to 1500 degrees centigrade. The maximum furnaces that are available in labs don't go above 1000 degrees centigrade. So you need a special furnace for this. This furnace can go up to 1650 degrees centigrade. And second, what its best feature is in its name as an in-fire HPC speed. So the speed is, it goes up 300 degrees centigrade per minute, the grind rate of the temperature. You can mill a single zirconia crown within 10 minutes and zirconia framework within 90 minutes. And because of it is a laboratory sintering machine, you can mill 30 to 40 crowns at one time. So this is the advantage of this machine. Thank you.